This video, in its entirety, comes directly from a recent episode of On Assignment, which is hosted by Richard Engel. Our contribution was simply heavy editing.
It's a game the U.S. and Russia have been playing for decades. In the Cold War days, Mad Magazine called it spy versus spy. But the truth is, it was always the Russians who excelled at cloak and dagger to turn Americans into Russian agents. In Russia, a former KGB agent, Vladimir Putin, came to power and made rebuilding and re-energizing the spy agencies a top priority. And last year, Putin launched the biggest spy game yet, a multi-pronged attack on American democracy that some have called the political equivalent of 9/11. The game is on, and the stakes have never been higher.
If most people thought relations between Moscow and Washington would improve after President Trump took office, instead today, they have reached a new low. No matter what the White House team does, the story of the possible collusion between the Trump team and the Kremlin just won't go away. But what if we've been all looking at this backwards? What if taking over our national agenda was the whole point? What if we've already taken the bait?
Ideologically, Vladimir Putin is our enemy. The ideals we hold near and dear, like liberty and freedom and democracy, are an anathema to President Putin. We should start with that and remember that.
What do you think Putin's overall goal is?
He wants, I would say, three overarching goals: interfere with our electoral process, interfere with our governing process as well, and then elevate Russia's stature in the world so that we perceive Russia to be on the same level as the United States.
Hoffman believes that Putin and the Russian intelligence services set President Trump and his team up for failure. He focused on that now infamous meeting between Donald Trump Jr., Paul Manafort, Jared Kushner, and five other people whose names leaked out to the press one after the other.
Russian intelligence would not send a bevy of Kremlin-connected influential Russians all together to a meeting.
So you think they did want us to find out about this meeting?
Absolutely did.
The initial invitation came in the form of an email with a tantalizing offer of high-level and sensitive information that would incriminate Hillary. Donald Trump Jr. wrote back right away, "If it's what you say, I love it." Hoffman says the email was what professionals call a poison pill and that the Trump team swallowed it whole.
Statement to
Hoffman believes that once the Trump team took the bait, Putin was counting on the free press in America to do what it does best, investigating and exposing all the details.
Some U.S. officials suspect him of having ties to Russian intelligence.
I think Vladimir Putin understood that this would lead to a media feeding frenzy, which is what we've seen, and a great deal of time and effort being focused on this issue that would ultimately interfere with our governing process, drive a wedge among different elements of our government.
Just like the ones about other members of Trump's team, their credibility and that of the administration is called into question daily as investigators and the media uncover clue after clue, always looking for that smoking gun, but never quite finding it.
Do you think we're ever going to find something that wasn't laid down for us, that wasn't part of the trap?
I think if the media can discover the breadcrumbs, then they were deliberately placed.
What Hoffman is saying is that the Russians have already achieved their goal. They set the traps and then sat back and waited for them to snap shut, unleashing chaos.
Russian intelligence officers have been fond of saying that there are useful idiots who can do the bidding for us.
And what is a useful idiot from Russia's perspective?
Someone certainly not very sophisticated about the ways of the world and the ways of the intelligence world.
Does President Trump fit that category?
No comment.